One, of course, as the sun goes down, it's not as bright and lighted as well. So with that, with the environment getting darker, they can't see as well. Now, when we studied about hormones, you know your hormones control your body. Well, toward the end of the day, you know, it's getting time for sleep, your body needs to rejuvenate, so the production of hormones from your pituitary, your adrenal, your adrenaline, you know, everything starts to slow down also, because it's getting ready for sleep. So with that decreased, you know, hormones that run our body and tell our body how to work, if they're kind of decreasing in combination with the darker rooms, I think all those, plus the need for sleep, because they've been up all day, all kind of combines all together where a lot of times people can get confused. A lot of people get confused because they're low on oxygen. Well, a lot of people, as the days progressed on, you know, they've been walking, they've been busy, they've been doing this. Well, maybe toward the end of the day, they're not getting enough oxygen. Not enough, they're not going to be sent into a crisis, but it's just enough decline in oxygen to the brain where some confusion starts to happen. So sundowning is a real thing. Trigger validating validation therapy. The therapy that lets the people with Alzheimer's disease believe they are living in the past or imaginary. This is like mirroring them, validation therapy. Violent wandering, of course, wandering, going around facility. This along with pacing can be one of those subtle hints that they're getting ready to elope. A wandering person is looking for something, and you know, looking for what? You know, it could be the bathroom. It could be, where's another sandwich? I'm hungry, but it could be for a way out. That's why all your doors are all going to be alarmed. You know, they're going to have codes when you punch out. And like I said, be really careful that a resident's not looking at you, you know, kind of cover the box if they're around there, do something, because you don't want them to see, because they could. Go through and review the structure functions of the nervous system. The neurons, probably the most important thing, that is the basic unit. You know, like the alveoli is the basic unit for the lungs, the neuron, nerve cell, is the basic working unit for the nervous system. You've got your brain and your spinal cord. Of course, the brain is like your computer. The spinal cord is literally how nerve impulses, motor, get sent out, sensory come back. And of course, you know, if the spinal cord is cut, for the most part, wherever the spinal cord is cut, that person will become paralyzed from there on down. So a lot of people, if the spinal cord is cut around the waistline, they're going to become a paraplegic, probably will lose bladder control more than likely. The higher up the cord it goes, of course, the more that you know, they will suffer in loss, because it just simply will not transmit any of the messages. So it just creates a huge loss. You guys probably know, like the guy that played Superman, Christopher Reeve. He cut his in the cervical area so high that why he ended up on a ventilator was because he cut what was called the phrenic nerve. The phrenic nerve goes off from the spinal cord to control the lungs. So when that happened, of course, no controlled lungs, he wasn't able to breathe. So people can cut it up so high that they will die. You know, if he had no one around him, he probably would have died, because when you cut in the cervical area here, about the, you know, you cut that phrenic nerve, it's over. You're not going to breathe. You're not going to die. Now, if I understand what happened to him,